go. Up in lights, he just wants to be heard, whether it's the beat or the mic. He feels so unlike everybody else, alone, in spite of the fact that some people still think that they know. But no, he knows the code. It's not about the salary, it's all about reality and making some noise, making a story, making sure his click stays up. That means when he puts it down, Tox picking it up. Let's go.
Who the hell is he anyway? He never really talks much, never concerned with status, but still even in starstruck. Humble through opportunities given despite the fact that many misjudge him, cause he makes a living from writing raps. Put it together himself, now the picture connects. Never asking for someone's help, but to get some respect. He's only focused on what he wrote, his will is beyond reach. And now it all unfolds, the skill of an artist.
This is 20% skill, 80% fear. Be 100% clear, cause Ryu was ill. Who would've thought he'd be the one that set the West in flames? And I heard him wreck it with the crystal method, name of the game. Came back, dropped Megadeth, took him to church. I like Bleach, man, Ryu had the stupidest verse. This dude is the truth, now everybody giving them guest spots. His stocks through the roof, I heard him f***ing with that style.
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name.
They call him Ryu, he's sick, and he's spitting fire and Mike. Got him out the dryer, he's hot, found him in Fort Minor with top, but a f***ing nihilist porcupine. He's a the type women wanna be within rappers, hope he gets 8 years in the making, patiently waiting to blow. Now the record with Shinoda's taking over the globe. He's got a partner in crime, his is equally dope. You won't believe the kind of that comes out of this kid's throat top.
He's not your everyday on the block. He knows how to work with what he's got, making his way to the top. He often gets a comment on his name. People keep asking him, was it giving that birth or does it stand for an acronym? No, he's living proof. Put a rock in the booth. He'll get you buzzing quicker than a shot of vodka with juice. Him and his crew are known around as one of the best. Dedicated to what they do and give 100%.
Forget Mike. Nobody really knows how or why he works so hard. It seems like he's never got time because he writes every note and he writes every line. And I've seen him at work when that light goes on in his mind. It's like a design is written in his head every time before he even touches a key or speaks in a rhyme. And those other fellas he runs with, the kids that he signed, ridiculous without even trying. How do they do it?
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name. This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name.
If you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment that you captured, just let it slip.
Yo.
His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes rabbit, he choked. He's so mad, but he won't give up. He won't have it, he knows. His whole back to these ropes, it don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's pro. He's so stagnant, he knows. When he goes back to this mobile home, that's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old rhapsody, better go capture this moment and hope it don't do it. Lose his health in the music, the moment you own it, you better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime, you better lose his health in the music, the moment you own it.
This world. National Intercollegiate Men's Wheelchair Basketball National Championship behind
between number 2 seed Alabama and number 1 seed Texas Arlington. Alabama comes in with a record of 24-7. UTA, the Moving Mavs, come in at 24-6, looking for their first ever national title. But again, talking with Miles Thompson before the game, and the Alabama head coach tells me he believes this is the time for his team. The Alabama starters today: Bo Hedges, Yannick Blair, Jared Arambula, the leading scorer, Mark Booth, and Ryan Hines for the Moving Mavs. Booth gets it back over to Hedges. Booth drains another one. It's a three ball. He's got all 8 Alabama points. It's 8-4. Arambula penetrates, kicks to Booth. Booth again. Got another one. Jared used those long arms to his advantage. Tries to drop it down and does for Hines. Kilworth brings it up. Kilworth drives, gets by the defender, and scores the layup. Kilworth shoots it. He got it. Misses. Arambula's got it. Kilworth breaks away. Defender's closing quick. Layup is good. For the Tide, he's yet to score. Inside, nice pass to Kilworth. 5. They end the half on a 9-0 run, so Alabama now just 20 minutes away from its first ever national championship in the wheelchair game. It's halftime. Booth for game-high honors. Good job by Alabama on offense. Arambula, good look to Hedges. Layup's good. Oh, Arambula, what a steal. He'll try to outrace Kraft for the basket. Comes in, layup good. Gives it back to Arambula. Arambula, the senior from Valparaiso, Indiana, to Kilworth, who's also from Indiana, from Carmel. And Kilworth knocks down the shot from the free throw line. It's a 6-point game. Gets a screen. He'll shoot it. Nothing but the bottom of the net. A 3-ball for Arambula. Jared Arambula, Alabama by 9. Oh, Hines got open underneath. Defensive breakdown by the Mavs. This is a 17-2 run. And capture its first national championship. Booth throws it into Kilworth, and you can paint this one crimson. Alabama wins it over UTA 71-52. Another national championship is coming home to the capstone. Alabama gets 21 from Jared Arambula, 18 from Mark Booth, who had 13 in the first half. 10 apiece from Hines and Kilworth, 8 from Hedges. UTA got 18 from Sanchez, 12 from Kraft, 12 from Gans, 8 from Soto, and 2 from Mauricio Jr. But Alabama wins it, 71-52. Head coach Miles Thompson and his assistant, Ford Bertram. Welcome back, everybody, to the Hell South Fieldhouse at the Lakeshore Foundation in Homewood, Alabama, where Alabama has just won the first ever men's national intercollegiate wheelchair basketball national championship, 71-52 over UTA. Let's turn it over to our public address announcer, Wild Bill, for the presentation of the medals.
You know, Gary, you were there. You know, you saw us lose an overtime game for third place in Texas 2 years ago. You saw us last year. This group has paid its dues. This group, I've asked so much of this group, and they have they've responded with the kind of performance you see today. It feels good.
I wanted to ask you about that. This core group of players has been with you for 3 or 4 years, and as you said, you've gone through these growing pains, and then to be here today in Alabama hosting the event to win the first national championship, that's just got to be a dream come true.
Well, you know, I worked and coached high school basketball in this gym for 10 years, so it literally has come full circle. And it feels good. It feels really good.